So, in the beginning of December or November, no, by December or November 2018, I started going to an alternative high school. And when that happened, I was introduced to another environment in which things were much different than a traditional high school. For me, it was more of a vulgar, inappropriate place. And the first day there, I witnessed a fight and drank Snapple as I walked towards it. That's how I knew I loved the school. That's how I knew that I was going to love the school. And so, being introduced to this new environment, there's a lot of teachers that when they first get there, they don't know how to handle stuff. I had a history teacher who was apparently there for 1 month. So he was pretty much there for like the month that I came in. He was new with me, I guess. And by the time of January 2019, that teacher had already gone to some other school. And so, in place of that teacher, another history teacher came in. Now, I only talk about this teacher because I feel that it's something that I think is special to me, just in general, the topic of teachers and students. For me, when it came to teachers, I always felt like I wanted to learn more about them because I'm spending a lot of time listening to them, like talking to them, and I never really get to know so much about their personal life. I feel like I would like that in general. I would like to know that just generally with strangers. It's quite odd, I think, to want to know the life story of strangers, but really, I feel like there is a story to be told just with random people on the street, in the mall, or whatever. And that's what really is attractive to me, is learning stories and being able to get into them and feel emotions with the person. That's what I love. I love that type of like deep talk, that type of talking about life or talking about the hardships of life. And so this teacher comes in, and the first day there, she doesn't know what she's doing, it seems. She's like scrambling around, like trying to find papers and whatnot. It's her first day, and we have her, I think, not first period. It was a period. And she was scrambling around, trying to find papers. And I had looked, and then I was like, I stood for a second because I was like surprised. And so, she introduced herself and tried to get to know the students a little bit more. She asked like what we liked, like what shows we liked, what music we liked. She talked about what she liked, and apparently, like some students, including myself, had some interest in a show as she did. The show was Shameless, which is a show right now on Showtime. We're talking about the US version. So we talked about that. You know, we apparently kind of like just related on some kind of level. What was very interesting about her that I don't really like to put out there generally with people, but I guess it's important to the story, is how young she is. I don't want to give out her age or whatever. I want to give as little information about her as possible to protect her privacy. But she is extremely like young compared to the teachers I've had, because usually, you know, I have teachers who are mothers already and they're married, and they have, you know, had quite the history in the school or in schools in general. No, this was her first year in teaching. We were her first batch of kids. And so, yeah, people, she, I guess she had a strange way of teaching, in the sense that she's like an engagement monster. Like she will try to get the students engaged. She'll do all of this stuff to try to get their attention. She'll do a lot of hand gestures to try to get their attention. All right, everybody. And I love that. I love when a teacher isn't like, quite honestly, like a bitch. I especially remember this one teacher who just really, really made me feel bad, and I really remember that. It was in 7th grade, and I remember just like feeling really bad about myself because of that teacher. And that's what I've taken from that teacher from that year. And when I was in like 8th grade, or the end of 7th grade, I think, I was in trouble to where I was in like the principal's office, and she had passed by, and I had smiled at her, and she just, like, looked at me with, like, a derogatory look, and then shook her head and looked away, and I remember that. And I remember that teacher by like, the negative feelings that she would give me. And so when it came to this, to when it comes to any teacher who respects me, that I really appreciate that. Not like the other teacher didn't respect me, I guess they did. In her defense, I guess she tried to get us to do the homework and try to make it so that we pass. Because, well, in New York State, for every student that does not pass your class, you're deemed not fit for teaching, as far as I know. And so it's important to get those students to pass. This teacher, this new one, and the history teacher, I never, like, felt negative about her. She never treated me badly. She always actually made me feel opposite. I felt better after attending her class. We were just learning history and whatever and stuff, but just the way she engaged with us was very respectful. And she was quite fair, and she was very, very nice with us. And I feel like that has gone a long way to where this is, like, I'm talking about her right now. But one thing that I feel touched about is she was thanking her students at the end of that year, and I'd come out in class that going to that alternative high school had been the best decision I'd made in my high school career. And I remember that made her cry. She, like, put her head down into her hand and whatever, and she, like, she cried. Yeah. No one in the class really paid attention. They were kind of talking amongst themselves, but I paid attention. And knowing that she felt really strongly about that comment and seeing how much she cared about her students really, like, touched me in a way. Another thing that I really took with me is that Day of the Regents. It was the first day, and if you don't know what regents are, they're like a state test. You have to pass the regents in order to acquire your high school diploma. Like, I know a person who actually didn't pass the regents, but the system pushed them through anyway, and they got the diploma. But technically, yeah, you're supposed to get these tests to get your diploma. And so I was taking that, and I panicked like I never had before. You can clearly see me panicking during this test. I never did that before. And what I remember from that is that she was proctoring the test, and she came to my desk, and she looked me in the eyes and told me, don't worry, I'm here, it's okay, I'm here. Months later, when I was going to see my friend, Crystal, I was afraid that she might be tricking me into something really bad. That's probably just because of skepticism that may be there, or I don't know. I feel like I've been growing up in a type of mentality that where, like, horrible things can happen to me, and I don't know if that was gonna happen with me and Crystal. And so on the way to Crystal, at that time in that park, I remember her words. It was months after the test, or sometime after the test, and I remember her looking at me, telling me, "It's okay, I'm here, don't worry, it's going to be alright." So, to, like, the teachers there who, I don't know, whatever teachers watch my channel, whatever, I feel like that is really important, because it goes even beyond the subject or the teach me how to do this thing. Like, it's some type of help that resonates with me and that will resonate with me. The other teacher, her negativity and the way she made me feel resonated with me, definitely. But this teacher, I have just positive things to say about her. Unfortunately, I still have her for economics. I don't want to give out the name of the teacher. If you know her, then congrats. I don't want to, like, disclose the name of her or whatever. I want to protect her privacy. But I did want to share that, because that was important to me. That touched me. That was something I definitely felt like I wanted to share. She's been one of the teachers that has made me feel genuinely happier after leaving their class. I'm so happy to have had her and the teachers there at the alternative high school. I'm still attending the high school at the moment. And if they see this video, hello, how you doing? Alright, so that is the video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope I didn't put her or anybody else on the spotlight. I hope they're okay. And honestly, if you're watching this video, I mean, unless you're a terrible person that deserves it, I hope that you are okay too. Even then, we do terrible mistakes. Even smart people do terrible mistakes. And not all of us are doing smart things at one time. So, I don't know, maybe you're a terrible person, but one day you change that, I don't know. But I hope you're okay. I hope that the teachers keep on inspiring students. And I do hope for the best for this teacher, that she can reach her goals and live life the way she wants to. Alright, thank you very much. Bye!